These things take 450 years to decompose. Did you know that? Because I sure didn't. But when I found out, I decided I was going to do something about it. And since I'm a photographer, that meant taking pretty photos. Check it out. Finding 10,000 plastic bottles turned out to be surprisingly easy. One of my friends, a producer by the name of Didier Katie, called up a whole bunch of different waste management centers and said, "Hey guys, I got this crazy friend of mine, he's a photographer, his name's Von Wong, and he'd like to put a mermaid on a couple thousand plastic bottles. Think you could spare a few for a week or two?" Tomra Systems came right back at us and said, "Sure thing, where would you like us to send the 50-foot truck?" My original idea was to store everything in a garage and clean things out of someone's house. But when Tomra said 50-foot truck, I was like, dang, we're gonna need a warehouse.
I think we might have a little too many bottles. That's probably like what we make, what we produce in this city in like an hour. It's crazy.
And that brought us straight to the next problem. After all, where does one start looking for a 50 by 50 foot warehouse space? I reached out to an old friend of mine by the name of Alex DeCary. I shot his wedding about 5 years back and I knew he was in the flooring business. And I just asked him, "Hey, I got this crazy conservation photo shoot project planned. Any chance you might have some contacts that might be able to lend us some flooring space?" Turns out that Alex now owned his own company by the name of Power Decor with tons of warehouse space, and he was more than happy to not only lend us a small patch of his warehouse for the shoot, but also pieces of flooring for us to pull together one of the shots. With warehouse and bottles out of the way, the only thing left to do was figure out how to clean, delabel, unscrew, like, 10,000 bottle caps. I was gonna need some help. I spammed every single social platform I had available, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, inviting people to come out and have the most exciting experience of their life cleaning plastic bottles. Somehow, miraculously, on day one, we ended up with 10 volunteers. Progress initially was a little bit slow, but once we figured out the system, that's when things got zipping along.
We've got a full assembly line set up right now. We got one person to cut the labels, one person to rip them off, one person to screw up the caps. Oh, there's Coke dripping down me. Today, it's been pretty awesome. Voila. But we still have this for tomorrow. It's gonna be awesome.
By the next day, we were pros because we already knew the best way to achieve maximum efficiency. Assembly line.
Day two, tackling even more bottles, but this time around we have my buddy over here who's gonna be rigging up our camera onto the ceiling with plywood and ropes. It's gonna look awesome.
My vision for the final photos was to have a unique aerial perspective so that we could arrange all of the plastic bottles in a unique pattern so that the mermaid would have something interesting to interact with. To do that, we had a variety of different ideas, from drones, C-stands, even a cherry picker. But finally, we settled on a tried and true piece of technology, thousands of years old, and that was ropes, pulleys, and plywood. Guillaume Briand, an experienced rigger and good friend of mine, came by and designed a custom T-shaped structure capable of controlling tilt, roll, and yaw by simply pulling on the ropes.
Pretty happy with the rig. I've run it up and down a few times, so I'm getting really comfortable with it. Adjusting tilt and angles, I can see that it might be a little bit slow to get used to, but once you get it, you get it. So
while all this was happening, bottle cleaning production just kept going strong. But as the day slowly crept past, we realized that we might just be running out of time to finish the endless pile of bottles. Just when all hope was lost, my parents and grandparents dropped in with reinforcements, adding new energy and manpower to the group. And just like that, the hardest part of the photo shoot was now over. Tune back in this time next week to see the actual photo shoot happen. Like, comment, subscribe, and see you guys around next time.